Should I talk now? Okay, I think got lag. Yeah, so I also cannot see y'all. All I see is like this weird wall because her camera pointing outward. If my Singlish sounds worse than normal, it's because I've been overseas for like kana sai 2 weeks and nobody to talk Singlish to. So I apologize if it's over Singlish and then y'all don't understand. Oh wait, look, the office very nice. Chill lah. Hello, beautiful people. Hello, thank you for coming to Talk.CSS. Clearly more of you show up when you're not there. I sensing a pattern here. Maybe next time I should just not show up, right? Also can. Never mind. Okay. So wait. I'm new to this Hangouts thing. Okay, hello everybody. This is like HTML and CSS news for October 2019. It's the start of Q4. I think there was a very busy Q3. Then Q4, everybody starting to dial down. Cause like in December, people in Angmoh country don't work on, right? Anyway, there's not much going on in browser land. But DevTools 78 got something new. Unfortunately, it's mostly JavaScript API and rendering performance stuff. The only interesting thing I can think of is like you can now file DevTools issues from main menu. Fun fact, because I've been hanging out with a lot of like browser people this week, turns out that like Chrome is now putting more investment into their DevTools. Must be because Firefox DevTools damn tokong. Then now they also need to catch up. So it's good, it's good. They all can go and fight each other, and then we got better DevTools. Another interesting browser thing is that Firefox is now moving to 4-week release cycle. So normally, I don't know, if you got cut every month, you see every other month, then I got Firefox news. So instead of 6 to 8 week cycle, they're not from Q1 2020, they're going to move to 4-week cycle. So that means every month, I got something to say about Firefox, which is quite fun. Then specification also not much. And I think if you also come very often, you'll realize that the spec update kind of burst one. Like 1 month, walao, 6 all update, then 1 month nothing. But there's this interesting spec that I came across. It's not like an official spec, it's more of like a proposal like that. So there's this, can see the window, it's called scroll to text fragment, but it's a proposal. Yeah. But I think it's quite an interesting idea. So it lets you like specify text snippet in the URL. But other than that, if you go to this particular repository, because it's on GitHub, it's WICG. Actually, a lot of interesting things. You know, like nothing better to do with your life. You can go and see. I got a lot of like interesting proposals or like spec. Now the latest one, web USB. It's actually quite interesting. So if you got nothing better to do your life, can go and find out. Okay. So because there's not a lot of news, I can highlight some of the more interesting articles. So like this, you see this one got a lot of interesting articles. Some of the title, them talk on, like naming things is hard, but like two browser want to scroll by, it's a good title. Anyway, first one is very interesting. It's called about data overflow and data loss in CSS. If you didn't know that CSS also can have data loss, then that's why you must go and read this article. A bit long, but so you can break it into chunks or can be like toilet reading. You in the morning you go toilet, then you have nothing to do, then you can read. Next one, this one very interesting. If like maths is your thing, right, you can do logical operations with CSS because now got CSS variables. So actually you can do the not la and XOR. So I think it's quite interesting implementation, this one. Can also go and read. The final one is like the two browsers want to scroll bar. Because scroll bar is actually very interesting. Right? If you're using Windows machine, then you go look at a Mac machine, then you go look at Android phone, all the scroll bar are different one. So it's quite interesting to see if potentially you can do something about it. Like CSS is trying to give us ways to sort of like style the scroll bar a bit, but I think there's a lot of like back and forth. They're like, should we or should we not let the system do or whatever? But I think it's still a very interesting thing to go and read about. Then interesting code pen. This one must shout out because this is Olivia one. I realized that from now on, every time Olivia do something, like Twitter go mad. So this is the latest one that she did. It's a magazine layout. Damn chill lah. So can go and find out. Can go and look at more things that Olivia did. Another fun one is this one. Cause it's Pixel, so I shout out. But anyway, everything is in the GitHub repository under the notes, or like if you got subscribed to if you're the one of like, I don't know, 9 people who subscribe to our newsletter, you also get it in email lah. Okay, so that's it for news. Very short now. Because you all don't want to volunteer to speak, right? Now I have to dial in and speak. So if this doesn't go well, it's like too bad. Next time you all own self speak. Okay, so I can't remember the title of my talk, but it's something along like resizing browser one, right? So the point is that actually the talk is about like CSS flexible values. So traditionally, when we want to do like responsive design or that kind of thing, right, we will always use percentage. Percentage always percentage of something, right? So usually it's percentage of the parent abo is the percentage of the window if you use viewport unit. The problem is that if you size things with percentage, right, you're going to grow and shrink at the same rate. Like, so if you have a combination of text and image, because text, right, text can reflow, but image got intrinsic ratio, like got aspect ratio one. So usually, right, if you only use one set of size, one set of code, right, there's only a very specific width that it looks okay-ish. Like for this one, maybe like that. Because if the viewport too wide, oh, wow, then the picture then big. If the viewport too small, oh, then the picture cannot see, then the text also very like squishy. That's because everything has to change at the same rate when you use percentage. But what's interesting about like the new CSS layout, so specifically grid, because grid right now has the most of these so-called flexible sizing units. So grid got FR. I'll explain what all these values mean, but grid got FR, got min max value, then got the different content sizes, got like fit content, then got like auto. So all these, right, is very interesting because when you put them together, right, they don't grow and shrink at the same time. So yeah, we go to this other demo. Okay, it's not a very exciting demo. Wait. Got color key. FYI, console can zeng one, you know. You can zeng your console until you got a lot of color. If you are interested, they got nothing better to do your life. So let's discuss this. Let's discuss FR. FR actually means make this look nicer. So this first example, right, is 1FR, 2FR, 1FR. Actually, FR is just what it means is like it's a fraction of free space available in the grid container. So in this particular grid, right, everything FR, so it's quite straightforward. So if you go and look at the, I think it's very small, but I just read out, right, this second box is 428, the first box is 214, so it's like double. Because this one 2FR, this one 1FR, this one 1FR. Okay, that's quite straightforward. For auto, like, auto will generally everything same width. If it needs to take up more space, it'll just everything sort of distribute evenly. That is also fine. But auto actually acts a bit like max content. And you'll see this when you go to the third one. Because when you use separately, you cannot really see a difference. But when you use together, right, it's actually quite interesting. So for FR, because what FR is that any leftover space in the grid will automatically go to FR first. If got extra space, all will go to the green box. So let me switch back to my... Yeah. So in this viewport, right, got a lot of space, right? All the space will go to the green column. But the moment not enough space, all the space also first take away from the green column. The interesting thing is that the browser will keep taking space away from the green column. Even until now, the auto still keep its max content size. Only until the green column shrink, until it cannot shrink anymore. Then only the auto starts to shrink. Then eventually everybody will end up. Eventually everyone gonna end up the same. Everyone's gonna end up the same width. But what you notice is that if it were auto and FR, even just between these two, they grow and shrink at different rates already. So if you look between 3 and 4, right, the auto will never grow beyond the max content size. Then all the space will go to FR. But like for number 3, right, FR, all the space will take away from FR before the auto start to shrink. So I think that's quite interesting. What's even more interesting is the next set, which is fit content versus min content. So if you look at the legend here, green is still FR, blue is auto. So fit content, right, how to explain? Fit content is this sizing unit where it's a range, like, so it's a range between the minimum content size and either the maximum content size or whatever unit you put inside here. I got a better example. Hang on. Okay, so for example, this one, right? you look at the Chinese box. So this column is min content. This column is max content. Then this column is feed content. So feed content now is feed content 300 here, right? The max content width for this one is about like 482. So when there's not enough space, right? If you use feed content, huh, it will shrink until min content. So it's like same size as this one. Then cannot shrink anymore because minimum content. Liao. But because it's called it's feed content 300, huh, when you grow, right, you grow until here, then it's stopped. Because now it's stopped at 300. So if we change this 300 to something bigger than the max content. So max content is about 482. Change to 500, right? This column will not grow until 501. It will grow until max content, then it stops. So it's like whichever value smaller, it becomes the maximum content size. So that's how feed content work. So when you come back to here, right, grid also got a different type of sizing, not different lah, another range value, which is min max. So min max is like self-explanatory lah. First value is the minimum, then second value is the maximum lah. So the syntax is that you put in two values into the function. So 200 is my minimum size, then 400 is the maximum size. Then it also will adjust lah, depending on what the amount of space is. So when you look at the, so we look at example 5 lah. We already say that if got extra space, we'll sure give to the green box one. So this one, this one we already expected liao. So but when there's not enough space, right? Like the moment FR start to shrink, oh, keep shrinking and once it reaches its minimum size, the blue box and the orange box will shrink at the same rate. And they will hit the minimum content size at the same time. Okay? So like that, maybe a bit boring. The example 6 a bit more exciting. And then it will involve a bit more browser resizing. So if we look at this example 6, got yellow box, got blue box, got orange box. So the yellow box, right, is the min max. Then the orange box is the feed content. So when they got a lot of space, all the space go to auto. So auto will grow. But when there is not enough space, right, the content will be the size will be taken away from auto first. Take away. But then when you hit this size, right? When you hit here, which is the maximum content size, right? The auto doesn't shrink anymore. The min max will start to shrink. So at this point, min max is at 400. 400. When auto hit the max content, right, then min max start to shrink now. Shrink, huh? But like shrink. 到一半, I mean, shrink until halfway, the other two boxes start to shrink. So the exact point where this shrinking of all three boxes, I don't know exactly when, but it is a point which allows all three boxes to end up in their minimum size at the same time. So they'll all hit their minimum size more at the same time. So for the yellow box, minimum size is 200. For these two, the blue and the orange, right, the minimum size is the min content size. So if you see here, it starts to shrink already. Everyone starts to shrink at this point. Because this is the point where all three of them will shrink at the same rate and hit their minimum content size at the same time. And then when there is a lot of space, so again, if we grow, when we grow, right, the min max will grow. And then it will kind of like stop growing. Okay, let's explain this in words. If there's a lot of space, right? You look at the orange box, huh? Ayah, shit. Wait, Turn it off and on again. Okay, I think maybe this doesn't make any sense to all of you because I cannot hear what you ask. I cannot hear any response from you. I'm just staring at my own browser and resize. But anyway, let me try to explain. When there's a lot of space, the feed content is, oh, no, wait, why like that? Computer hanging. Sorry again. At first, feed content will grow. It will grow until, but then it will grow until 200, then it stops. Because that's the cap. But after it hit the cap, right, then auto and min max will continue to grow. But once auto hit the max content size, right, it's not going to grow anymore. It's going to let the yellow box continue to grow until it hit 400, then only it starts to grow. So the point of all this browser resizing is to show you that with this type of units, your items will not grow and shrink at the same rate. And
because of that, right, you can do quite interesting things. Let me show a more recent example other than color boxes. So yeah, this one and then this one. So this is two layout that look quite similar. They look quite similar at a big viewport size, but this first one is used percentage. Then the second one is used the let's call it flexible sizing lah. So at a wide screen you can't really see a difference. But it's gonna become very obvious when you get to a narrow screen size. Because you can start to see right the percentage or the image already start to become very small. And then the text start to squish out together already. So I think under normal circumstances, around this width, you're gonna start to put in another media query or to adjust the percentage. The difference between this one and the bottom one is, if I hide this one, right, this is the one with the variable sizing. The variable sizing at a big screen is nice, but as it goes down, right, the image still managed to keep the decent size, and your text also you can stretch it out longer. If I highlight a column, it's slightly complicated because I put a lot of values inside. But the advantage of this is that you don't really have to use media query. You can just let, so this particular layout, right, is more solid across a wider range of viewport, like, you know what I mean? And because you're using grid makes it easy to do overlap. So if you look at it's actually it's a 9 cell, so it's three row, three column, right? To let this title overlap this is overlap the image very easy. You just have to like say, oh, I want my title start at column 2, start at row 2. The text will just overlap the image. The first one, right, I had to use like float. Then you see the negative, very disgusting negative margin. Yeah. So it's like it's a bit not nice lah, you know what I mean? So if you use grid got a lot of advantages. So this overlap thing, another good thing about this overlap thing is that if you are familiar or if you want to try out other things, right, you can do this kind of funny things all with blend mode. If you don't know what is blend mode, huh, you go to the Talk.CSS 38, right? I think there's a 35-minute video of Gao Wei talking about how blend mode works. So yeah, if you never come, go and watch the video. But the long story short is that because it's so easy to do overlap, right, you can do kind of funny things. So then, a bit more creative lah. That potentially, you know, like if I'm viewing it on a very narrow screen, then maybe like that. But if you have a very wide screen, then like James McAvoy got like different color. I have an in-joke about James McAvoy. When I go back home, I tell y'all. But what I mean to say is that if you use, it's worth going to try out all these like new layout features, because then you can do a lot of things that last time cannot do, or last time it's like very hard to do. But now it's actually quite easy, and then you can like extra, you can zeng even more than before. Lor. Last time we had to zeng, but now it's quite easy to zeng. Yeah. So basically, that's it. That's it. I think I resized the browser until just now. Already crashed 2 times already. So let's stop doing this. Like that lor. See you all next month. I hope.